the 10 years of Armada, and we have with us Toby Hedges, that was playing at the second room of Armada. How was your performance there?
Yeah, it was good fun. It was a really good crowd. Obviously towards the end, that's when Armin was about to play, so the crowd sort of filled away. But yeah, it was really good fun, and yeah, I really enjoyed it.
Would you like to tell us, how did you start your career then? Which track was the one or remix that gets the attention?
I think I started, I've always loved music, like music's always been like the biggest part of my life. I probably started really getting into trance music when I was about 14. And I thought, I was about 16, and I thought, you know, actually I'd love to produce this. So it's taken about 4 or 5 years, but yeah, I mean, I think the first track that really got me recognised was Chasing the Sun. But that's a long time ago. That's about, well, it's only about a year and a half ago, but it feels like a long time ago.
How did you start your career? Did you start by going to college and learning how to produce, or are you self-taught?
Not really. I mean, I think sometimes, I mean, colleges do, they do a fantastic job, like, teaching, but I think you have to have the drive and determination to just, like, do it on your own. That's what I've always done. Like, I just kind of got the software. You can, tutorials are amazing online, but you just got to kind of just experiment, and the biggest thing is patience and time. That's the two key factors you need, and like, if you love the music and you keep enjoying it, you'll get there eventually.
You have cooperated with some great labels, among them is Anjunabate, so of Above and Beyond.
Yeah.
What is your relationship with them, with Anjunabate?
Yeah, I mean, Above and Beyond picked up my tracks quite early on the radio show, and they were always getting played on Group Therapy. And it was See the Sun, my remix to See the Sun, when Anjunabate got in touch and they wanted me to remix Ronsky Speed's Pink Sky, which, you know, was a massive moment for me, because Anjunabate is one of the labels that I've worshipped like through my career, so that was really good. And after that, I've done a remix with Juventa, the Boom Drinks track, and maybe a collab on Anjuna in the future, but now I'm focusing on Armada.
Okay, let's say what's going on with Armada.
8 hours ago, Armin played my remix for his and Nervo's track. He premiered it on the State of Trance, so that's sort of the newest thing I've got on Armada. I'm not sure when that's going to get released, but that was really, truly a special moment for me. Like, remixing my idol was unbelievably really good.
Did you remix this track by Armin?
It took longer than it should have, only because it was such a big deal for me. Like, it wasn't just another remix, it was an Armin Van Buuren remix. Sometimes that can be good if you like, sometimes you want to relax, but at the same time, you know, it's an Armin Van Buuren remix. It's hard to relax, you want to just make it perfect. So I spent probably a good month and a half, 2 months doing this.
Did you afraid that maybe Armin did not like it and turn it down?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, everything goes through him and Armada. I was afraid. I just wanted him to like it. I wasn't really afraid of him not liking it. I just wanted him to like it. You know? I think that was my main priority.
Tell us a little bit about the future prospects.
I've got, obviously, Armin's remix coming out soon. I'm working on something for Klein Albert as well, the remix. 2014 hopefully will be a lot more originals, because I've done about 12 remixes in a row, which is, it's fun and it's good, like, it's great publicity and remixing rivals, but yeah, I really want to do some original stuff now, so hopefully that'll be 2014 will be a good year.
So do you plan also an album, or it is very early to talk about an album?
I think albums are sort of, they don't really happen anymore. They do, but it takes a lot of dedication to get an album together. And right now I just don't think I have that much time to spend maybe 8 or 9 months doing an album. It's quite difficult.
How do you define your sound? Are you progressive house? Are you trance? Or you don't like these categories and you think they're old fashioned?
There's a dirty word at the moment, which is trance. But for me, like, everyone's sort of saying, yeah, trance is sort of horrible electro. For me, like, I've grown up loving house, so I love trance. So naturally, I want something in between. Like, I take influences from both genres, and trance has got a really bad reputation is a word, but like that's the genre that I love.
Are you gonna play to other places?
Yeah, there's a few things lined up, nothing confirmed yet, but hopefully the next 8 to 12 months will be a lot more gigs.
So, okay. Thank you very much for your time. Good luck with all your productions.
Thank you.
We love your sounds, like the deep bass lines and the nice melodies.
That's what I try, that's my aim.
How do you try and you combine them so beautifully? Thank you very much for your music then.
Thank you very much.